Hadoop distribution, you know, whoop-de-doo, lots of people have their own Hadoop distribution these days, but also massively parallel database, GreenPlum database, a well-known massively parallel tool for big data analytics, in-memory data grids, and technology for doing very fast, high latency data computations. Okay, so basically, then what am I talking about here? So if you say, why am I standing up here talking about big data? I run a data science team in Asia Pacific that helps companies, typically large companies, execute early wins, early proof of concepts that demonstrate the value of big data and analytics. So the point of this presentation is basically to share some of the things we've learned in doing this over the last couple of years about how to build a data science practice internally. So I want to give you a few pointers because we've learned it's hard. Right, so a lot of you think, yeah, big data, very cool, very sexy, I want to do some of that. Guess what? It's hard. It's more than just downloading some software. It's more than just hiring a data scientist. There's a whole bunch of things that need to happen in order to get any value out of this. So that should probably resonate with what Gartner's telling us right here. So, you know, when we go out and we ask particularly medium and large enterprises, so, you know, what do you think about big data? Everybody says, yeah, big data, we're on top of it, we got it covered, we're doing stuff. And really, though, the stuff that they're doing, though, is most of them are still in the phases of determining how to get value from big data and defining the strategy. So that sounds like a lot of talking and not a lot of doing to me. And this is very common. Right, so this is not meant as an insult to anybody. This is extremely typical in what we're seeing out there. All right, this is only from a few months ago. This is Gartner, September 2013. So basically what we see in the market is a lot of companies say, yep, I'm bought into the idea of big data. I know that I can get some value out of big data analytics. But if I go ahead and spend $1 million on big data technologies and I mess up, I'm going to get fired. That's a common complaint. So my organization basically helps do proof of concepts that produce a business result, basically a business case that proves that doing something with predictive analytics will work, and that use that as a basis for a future investment. This as well. So the other thing we emphasize is selecting companies that want to do this internally, right? So we're not really a service provider, we're a software provider. We provide software solutions, like cloud-enabled, you know, the whole deal, right? Cloud-enabled, big data analytics software. But a lot of our vision is to help companies build this capability internally. That benefits us, and we think strategically that's the right thing for companies to look at. You know, they want to do big data analytics, and you probably don't want to engage a partner for 100% of that work. Probably a bunch of that needs to be taken internally into the customer, and they need to take ownership of these big data analytics initiatives, right? Why? The reason is that people lose sight of the whole kind of transition from apps to data to analytics and back to apps again, right? You know, the output of big data analytics nowadays is a lot of times it kind of stops here, right? They say, okay, we got our application, it's generating a whole bunch of data, we're putting it in a big storage area, then we're doing some analytics, and then we get a report. You say, yeah, that's good, what are you doing with that report? And they say, your biggest value at the end is, it's completing this circle, because if you don't complete the circle and end up just with a report that you have to wait a week on before doing anything, you lose the primary benefit, which is speed to decisions. And that's something we always talk about, so I'm very happy to hear, you know, the last presenter also talk about the need to define business case and actual usage before starting on big data, right? If you don't have that, you won't define the application of things, and you'll lose out, you'll miss out on the whole speed game. And that's a very common failing for a lot of companies we see undergoing the big data analytics transition. All right, so key lesson that we learned, number one, is that when we work with customers, the first thing we have to do is identify business goal, right? Long term and short term. Do identify something, an easy win that you can go solve with a proof of concept up front, but it better have a good pilot project idea that would be beneficial to your business. Then what? then what? So then customers will say, well, the next step is just to hire a data scientist, right? So I just go find one and hire them, and then they do magic on numbers. And we say, wait a minute, you know? Yes, it is apparently the sexiest job of the 21st century, so I've been told and am reminded of constantly. But it's more than just this. So one of the things we've come up with is looking at a framework for developing data scientists, right? So the classical definition that exists out there is a breakdown of business intelligence versus data science. And I'm going to say up front that I don't 100%, you know, this is only part of the picture, right? So when we say data scientist versus BI, a lot of this comes down to focusing on the what if, the predictive analytics side of things, you know, optimization, figuring out what will happen versus what did happen. All right, so that is part of the difference of being a data scientist. Data scientists is because these people with analytical backgrounds are playing a different role in organizations today than they did 10 years ago, right? So, you know, a lot of times when we talk about data scientists, we get caught up in this idea that these people are superhuman and they have analytical powers beyond what's typically found. And I concentrate that it's not actually the case. The reason people are using a new title, data scientist, is because they're doing something different in organizations, right? So this is a quote from DJ Patil, who was the founding member of the data science team at LinkedIn, and is credited with coining the title data scientist, right? And the whole reason that he had to come up with this is that data scientists were functioning alongside product management groups, right? So product management, innovation, that type of area. That's not usually where you find your analytics professionals if you go back 10 years. Right, so I always like moving companies forward, and it's a key thing that companies should realize and accept before charging forward with more. All right, and again, about the title, right? To just add some credibility, some evidence here, right? Go back 10, 20 years when people were talking about software and software architects, right? So if you were in the software industry at that point, and you would have heard lots of backlash about the term software architect. You said, what are these software architects, right? How are they any different than a software engineer? I don't understand what a software architect is. Yeah, this happened all the time in the 90s. And really the difference was they were playing a different role in the organization, so they got a new title. And nowadays we accept that, right? So nowadays we say, oh yeah, I kind of know what a software architect does as opposed to a software engineer. And people, and we've developed a framework to pick and select a few kind of key choices to develop this best, right? So when you look at the team structure, sure, data scientist is part of the mix. We focus on the fact that, again, data science is not, we don't want to put these people on a high pedestal and say, well, we could never find one, so we can never do data science, right? We want to focus on the fact that we've trained up a whole number of these people, and a lot of times the best data scientists come from a core technical background, right? Somebody with a STEM degree, somebody who has strong science and technology, usually computer science, but sometimes natural sciences. And it's usually those people then that have a good mind for that and a good mind for numbers, and they have a chief data officer, right? So New York Stock Exchange, real company, right? Not fake little, nonsense company, right? Real company. They have a CDO, they have a chief data officer, So there's lots and lots of companies actually executing on this right now. This is not, vision or something in the future. This is stuff that's happening now. All right, so take away from all of that, right? That was a framework. What's the point? Data science is a team sport. So state data science. And then we say, okay, well, let's get them some data. And then, all bad things happen, right? Then we say, no, you can't touch that data. That data is dangerous. You can't touch that. And you say, well, could we join it with the data over here in this business? No, you can't do that. Too dangerous, right? So every large company we work with has this problem. They all, before you get too deep. So we do have a proposal here. We've executed this a few times, 5 core kind of teams and specializations to really solve the data liberalization flow. All right, so data liberalization is part of developing data science, very important. All right, so just to give you an idea, what's curriculum then? So once you've gotten past all those pieces, then what are some of the curriculum that we would recommend? A lot of it is based on what's already been talked about here, a lot of R, a lot of Python. We focus a lot on in-database, parallel types of statistical work. So like the stuff that we've seen today, right, should indicate one very clear thing, and that's that we've been given a weapon, right? So the reason everybody's talking about big data analytics is that the technology exists to do stuff, right? So that's why everybody's up in arms. It's like everybody's given us a big, sword or bat, right? We know we can do something, and we know we can do something big. And what we're losing sight of is then what are we going to hit with that? What are we going to go do?